Welcome back to PCG Media's Weekly Roundup. This week, the Oculus Rift Developer Kit is now available to pre-order. Sony announces their own virtual reality prototype, Project Morpheus. From Software responds to claims of a Dark Souls 2 graphics downgrade. The Unity 5 game engine is announced at GDC. And PCG Media brings you the top 5 YouTube gaming channels of 2014, not including ourselves, of course. Oculus VR have announced they are now taking pre-orders for the Oculus Rift Developer's Kit 2, an updated version of the prototype that is currently being showcased at tech shows. The new headset will include positional tracking, low persistence and high resolution, putting it a step above the original prototype. However, the consumer version is expected to be even more improved, so if you just want a headset to play games on, it's best to wait for that version to be released in the future. The newer prototypes are believed to have mostly fixed the motion sickness problems that plagued the DK1. The DK2 costs $350 to pre-order, which works out as just over £200 in the UK, and orders are set to ship this July. Sony has revealed their own virtual reality prototype, Project Morpheus. Shuhei Yoshida, Sony Worldwide Studios president, stated, "VR has been a dream of many games creators ever since the computer game was invented. Many of us at PlayStation have dreamed about VR and what it could mean for the games we create. It is by no means the final prototype, but Sony is calling it the next innovation from PlayStation that may well shape the future of games." Sony also said that, like the Oculus Rift, this prototype also serves as the first development kit for PS4 developers who are as excited and enthusiastic about this space as us. From Software has responded to criticism that Dark Souls 2's gameplay is of lower graphics quality than the pre-release footage. The studio stated that players shouldn't see the pre-release footage as an accurate representation of the final product, and that there have been lots of changes and rejigs over the course of Dark Souls 2's development. Throughout the game development process, a game is constantly being balanced not only in gameplay ability, but also in the realm of resource management, stated a From Software rep. The PC release of the game isn't due until next month, so we'll have to see if computer gameplay manages to match up to the pre-release footage better than the consoles. The Unity 5 games engine has been announced at the 2014 Games Developers Conference. The new engine offers 64-bit as well as an audio overhaul and the Unity Cloud, a cross-promotional network which will allow developers to share ad units. Other developments on the new engine include a multi-threaded job scheduler, easier and incremental building of asset bundles, loading optimizations, and many other improvements. Unity 5 is available now for pre-order and includes the most recent version of Unity 4. Microsoft unveiled DirectX 12 this week, and unsurprisingly, the new version of the software shows a big focus on improving mobile forms of gaming. The new system helps to spread the workload, reducing the strain on the central processing unit. The news is good for tablet and laptop-based gamers who generally have to deal with weaker CPUs than PCs. An early access version of DirectX 12 is expected before the Christmas period of next year. You can't spend all your time on the PCG Media YouTube channel, so we've brought you our top 5 YouTube gaming channels of 2014. At number 5, we have Metal Jesus Rocks. This Seattle-based ex-Sierra developer certainly knows his stuff, and the footage of his gaming room available on the article is enough to make any gaming fan drool. At number 4 is The Angry Joe Show, my personal favourite. Oh yes, I'm a member of the Angry Army. Arguably as much a performer as a games journalist, Joe is a passionate gamer who is also heavily critical of any type of games-based unfairness, from rushed-out games to bribery of critics. Number 3 goes to Retroware TV, a celebration of gaming's retro years, as the name may have given you the hint. The channel's series, The Video Game Years, which takes us through the popular and groundbreaking games of yesteryear, is a good look even if you're not a particularly big retro fan. At number 2 is GameSack, another retro site. GameSack's content is incredibly well produced, well edited and well written. Their main show, also called GameSack, is on the longer side, from 15 to 30 minutes an episode, but it's well worth a subscription. And finally, taking the top spot is Lazy Game Reviews, last year's PCG Media number 2 gaming channel. A successful patron campaign has allowed LGR to expand their operations. In return for the funding, LGR promises more content and higher quality content. If you haven't already, check out these channels and enjoy. Got your own list? Think we've missed someone important? Let us know in the comments. Well, that's it for this week. Before you get distracted by all the other great channels, Make sure you check out PCG Media's Titanfall review, as well as our previews of Men of War, Assault Squad 2 and Age of Wonders 3. On the website, we also have an interview with Longbow Games, developers of Hegemony Rome, Rise of Caesar. See you next week.